United States. If Obama does it, it's bad. If Trump does it, it's good, or vice versa.
Yeah.
It is stunning to me. Human rights issues are human rights issues. What the Castros, the Kims, the mullahs in Iran, what they do has nothing to do with whether or not you like the president at that time. And so it's, yes, it's stunning to see that. I remember when I was covering for CNN the opening of the American embassy in Cuba.
Mm-hmm.
And we were covering a lot of the dissidents and their protests, the lack of freedoms in Cuba. And there was the exact opposite thing going on, where one channel, not CNN, not Fox, was praising this as an amazing moment of diplomacy. Well, we have since seen that there hasn't exactly been this blossoming of freedom in Cuba.
Mm-hmm.
And now we see the same thing. And that's why it's so unhealthy. I mean, that's why organizations like Amnesty or Human Rights Watch, Human Rights First, are groups that you have to focus on, because they don't look at it through who's president. I want to support the U.S. president. They look at it through what is going on in this country.
Human rights. So the president is coming back from this historic summit in Singapore, and he gave this news conference. And of course, he had left the G7 early in Canada and, you know, made a lot of news with regard to how he treated our good friends in Canada. And this is what he said in this news conference from Singapore about Justin Trudeau.
He gave out a little bit of an obnoxious thing. I actually like Justin. You know, I think he's good. I like him. But he shouldn't have done that. That was a mistake. That's going to cost him a lot of money.
For me, I just wanted to ask you, you think about the sort of spectrum, or the 24 hours, where on the one side, you know, he calls Trudeau noxious. And I know Peter Navarro has walked back his special place in hell, but still, it was said.
Well, the president called him a liar.
On the other end of the spectrum, you know, you have him, the handshake and the lavish praise of our foe.
Right.
I ran through, talk about human rights, you know, what's going on in North Korea on the other end of the spectrum.
It is a real disconnect. I mean, President Trump was elected to be a disruptor, and he is disrupting our normal alliances when it comes to trade and the G7. And he is disrupting the way that normally we do things with North Korea. To have these events so close to each other seems odd, because it seems as though he is
favoring
bad guys and dissing good guys.
Mm-hmm.
Now, in actuality, when you look at U.S. policy, obviously Canada remains a very close ally of the United States, and North Korea, we're still imposing, the U.S. is still imposing economic sanctions.
Mm-hmm.
But it is striking, calling Trudeau weak and suggesting he's not honest one breath, and then within a day or two, I mean, the comments he made about Kim Jong-un being smart and a great negotiator, and he loves his people, effusive praise for one of the most murderous, barbarous dictators on the planet. It's quite a thing. I think Eric Erickson has a point.
Yep. Hey, congratulations on your new book. I have no segue for that, but
oh.
It was great to be at the party.
Oh, thank you so
last
much.
Last night. And so just everyone, if you haven't, if you don't know, the big book, The Hellfire Club, which has been on the New York Times bestseller list. How many weeks?
4 weeks. 4 weeks it was on the bestseller list.
Tapper, congratulations.
Thanks so much, Brooke.
That's
and
awesome.
Congratulations to you.
Thank you.
On a much bigger achievement than a book.
Thank you very much. Mm-hmm. Appreciate it. Next, President Clinton steps in it again when it comes to this whole Me Too movement, how he's explaining the comment that, quote, norms have changed when it comes to what you can do to somebody against their will. Huh? CNN is, we're hearing they're suing the government, CNN suing the government to get access to the death records after Hurricane Maria. Moments ago, a judge sided with CNN in that case. We are live in San Juan next.